Hi, everybody. Welcome to today's co-video. This is Dr. Kestler from Lorain County Community College with the latest update. A few things I want to go over today. First of all, my temperature today is 97.5 Fahrenheit, or as I call it, fake degrees, and 36.4 correct degrees, or Celsius. First thing I want to talk about today is this issue of supplies. A lot of people have been asking me about supplies, and there are some coming, and there and I've had a lot of questions. I've been talking with a lot of my healthcare friends recently who are kind of concerned about running out of masks, about running out of all sorts of things. And I'll give a quick shout out to Barb and Haley and Amber, who I've been talking with in the last few days about this issue. And apparently we are running low on medical resources. You know, the medical community has run some numbers, and you can see that on this this slide about the number of possible cases with influenza and with COVID. COVID might require more kind of activity than influenza. And so you can see from these numbers that COVID could really plug up the healthcare system. That means the supplies are on the short supply. And so I'm just going to say something. You know, if you have a mask, and people have been asking me all about homemade masks and all sorts of things that are out there. And I'll say this, that a homemade mask is better than no mask for working in healthcare. So for those of you who have masks at home, and if you have extra, I would donate them to the healthcare. We donated a bunch of masks that we have in the laboratory to the healthcare system. That's an important thing to do. One of the things that we're going to try to avoid is making it like in many places in the world, they're forced to, when the healthcare system gets overburdened, somebody has to make some really, 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 really hard decisions about who gets to live. And you're looking at two patients and you've got one ventilator, and you have to make a real tough decision there. If the healthcare system is overburdened and we only have one ventilator, one person gets it and one person doesn't. So somebody dies as a result of that. So this is a really, really serious kind of an issue. And you know, we worry a lot about that. And you know, just think about the human toll of the people who are making those kinds of decisions. I think we want to continue staying home. And I know it's hard. You know, there's talk among people in government and the governors as the president and about returning back to work. Returning back to normal. And I think that we have to be very cautious about that, be very careful about that, and not do it too soon. I want to talk about the some data real quick, newly infected versus recovered. And I'm just charting newly infected, and you can see that we are just about heading into the storm. We are seeing a lot of newly infected people. We'll see more and more. If you are identified as being infected and you get well, that's great news, because that means that you can return to the fore. You can be the helper. You can be the one who goes back and helps make the things. But we're in the middle of this storm right now in the United States. Where we're not in the middle of the storm, I'll tell you, is Italy. And in the newly infected versus recovering in Italy, you can see that beautiful, beautiful drop at the end of the, on the yellow line on this curve, that beautiful, gorgeous drop where those numbers are coming down in Italy. And Italy is reaching the other side. And that is fantastic news. One other quick story I want to point out is we see this exponential. We ran, my group ran some numbers yesterday on, and I see this occurred in the New York Times today, which kind of models the, or mimics what we saw. And you can see places like South Korea. South Korea has figured out this whole thing by vigorous testing and figuring out who has and how to precisely put the right people into quarantine. If we know who to put into quarantine, that is a lot better than not knowing. So testing is still a huge, huge thing, and we're still waiting to catch up on the testing front. And then there's one other kind of testing. Last thing I want to talk about today is how do we identify who can be a helper? How do we identify who has recovered? Even though some of the early people and a lot of people will not have ever been tested, we have to realize that there are some of us who may have had this and gotten better, and we'd like to know who we are, because we can really return to kind of normal. We can go work, get a job at a grocery store right now, and be doing the great work that the people in the front lines of the grocery store are. What we need is an antibody test. The thing we need is an antibody test, and an antibody test will identify those that have recovered and may not even have known it. If you have antibodies, you are protected. You can go help out at the hospital. You can go help out at the grocery store. You can go visit people who need to be visited. And this is something that we desperately need in order to have it be effective. It has to be validated. That's one of the big things. You have to make sure that it is catching the cases that you think it is and not catching the cases that it should catch. It's able to identify people as being actually protected. And that we're going to have to figure out with time. I'll end really quick. Things are going to get really busy for me. I'll just tell you that we are going back to online classes tomorrow. So I'll try as best I can to get these things out there, but it is going to be kind of busy. I just want to remind you all to be good to each other and help be the helper, and hopefully we can find out who the good helpers are and persist like a lentivirus.